But you wait. You wait till the election is over, and then we will give you on the West Bank. Let me read these words. Let me read. I don't want to misquote the fellow. Yitzhak Shamir. He says here. He said, Yitzhak Shamir, the Israeli Prime Minister, has told Palestinians from the West Bank that the government might confer some authority on the occupied territories, but only after the Israeli elections later this year. Later this year. You have a chance of having your wishes fulfilled. This is the debate, is that the thing that is the word of God, then it's a natural thing that you have to listen, hearken. Whatever you are suggesting, the guy is saying that the autonomy, chance limited autonomy, running everything in the territory except security. Exactly, word for word. As if brother has been going there, he has been going there quite often. Soon after the 67 war, he was there within 6 months. After the 73 war, he was there. Pictures are given. He is ministering to wounded Israeli soldiers. Beautiful, beautiful. He's ministering to wounded Israeli soldiers. In more than 30 pictures in the Liberated Palestinian, there is not a single Palestinian refugee in the book. No picture. But Israeli soldiers, average of 2 pilgrimages. He's leading people from America on a pilgrimage to Palestine, 2 a year, average of 2 every year. What does it? This is belief. Once you believe that this is the destiny of your people, to become slaves, to become cannon fodder and foreskin fodder for the Jews, I said, now, is this the book of God? People with reason, tell them to the Palestinians. I would like to see a Palestinian go and tell the people in the Gaza, go and tell them that, look, from the Nile to the Euphrates, it should be given to the Jews. Southern Lebanon should be given to the Jews. What does it? This is the book has done the job, beautiful job, of enslaving the minds of people. Now, the Quran gives us a test. How are we to know whether a book is from God or not? It gives us a test. In Surah Nisa, chapter 4, verse 82, it says, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ. Do they not consider the Quran with care? Don't you see? وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ. Had it been from anyone other than Allah, لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافٌ كَثِيرًا. You would have found in it many discrepancies, contradiction. This is a test which we have to apply to any book claiming to be God. See whether it is consistent with itself or there are full of contradictions. I will only give you one. And I'm reading from the New Testament. John chapter 18, verse 9. John 18, 9. I'm quoting. That the saying might be fulfilled which he spoke. That the saying might be fulfilled which he spoke. Of those, in inverted commas, of those whom you gave me, I have lost none. Close of inverted commas. Of those whom you gave me, I have lost none. None means not one, not a single one. Who says that? Jesus. How do you know? It's in inverted commas. Ask any Christian preacher and he will tell you these are the words of Jesus. And in the Bible that's given to me, Brother Shurosh, thank you very much. This is called a red letter Bible. Red letter meaning every word that Jesus spoke is in red. So very easy to find out whether Jesus spoke these words or not. You open John chapter 18 verse 9 and it sees it is in red. Which means these are the words of Jesus. In the Bible, the fifth major revision. Words of Jesus. It means he lost none, not one. Out of the 12 that God gave him, he didn't lose a single one. But in John 17, just one chapter before, verse 12, same Jesus, he says, while I was with them in the world, I kept them in your name. Those whom you gave me, he's talking to God, you gave me, I have kept. And none of them is lost None of them is lost except the son of perdition, except one. Except one, Judas Iscariot. In chapter 18, he says lost none. 17, he says he lost one. What did he say? Did he say one or did he say none? Stupendous difference. Contradiction. One or none. They don't mean the same thing, do they? One and none. You just add an N, becomes none, but it's a world of difference between two. So the learned men of Christendom, very ingenious, very ingenious. In this book, the words that are in red, I have another Bible, another King James Version, the sixth major revision, another one here, also red letter, printed by the same Nelson Press, same printers, red letter Bible, you open it, chapter 18, verse 9, it is in black. It's in black. What happened? Look, they changed it. Red to black. Yeah. Because they saw that this is a contradiction. So to rectify the norm, but they're still in inverted commas. Who spoke the words? So he says, no, you see the difference is only one. I said, you know, in a court of law, if you testify like that, you say on one occasion one, another occasion you say none, you can be charged for perjury, bearing false witness, you know that? So now Jesus is in the box. Either Jesus, you put him in the box, ask him, did you say one or none? Oh, it was not Jesus. Jesus said, look, I knew nothing about that. Then you put John in the box. Hey, you wrote in chapter 17, one, and in chapter 18, you said none. How did you get that? But John is supposed to be inspired by the Holy Ghost. Who is the Holy Ghost? The Holy Spirit. Who is God? So now God is in the box. We put him in the box. Excuse me, sir, did you say in chapter 17, one, and in chapter 18, you said none? Did you? You know the difference in the meaning between one and none? Ask God. Look, we say, this is not the word of God. Can't you see? This is not the word of God. We are telling you. But he says, only difference is one. See, time is running out pretty fast. The Quran gives us a quality control. He says the Quran is here to confirm what is right, what is true in the previous revelation, and وَمُحَيْمِنًا عَلَيْهِ, and it is a guarding in safety, a protection of the previous revelation. Now let's see what it does. You see, in the book of God, the Bible, in the book of Exodus, we are told that Moses wants to see God. And God tells him, no man can see me and live. But he's insistent. He said, look, oh Lord, I love you. I must see you. So I'll do a favor. I'll put you between two rocks. And he puts his hand in the opening. God's hand. He puts in the opening. Then he turns his back and he takes away his hand. So Moses saw the back of God. He saw his back. He says, because my face can't be seen. You mustn't see my face. But the same book tells us that Jacob saw the face of God. Genesis chapter 32 verse 30, it says, and Jacob called the name of the place Peniel, for I have seen God face to face. Then, in Exodus chapter 33, verse 11, the same book where God says, no man can see me and live. Now he says, so the Lord spoke to Moses face to face, as a man speaks to his friend, not showing his back. Now we want to know, which is the word of God? Did Moses see him, or he only saw his backside? What is it? Why wouldn't God show his face? The face, the human face, you know this. Forget for a moment, forget it now, whether this is the book of God or not, forget it. Just on the human level, same sober level. God says in the Holy Quran,